A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 8th Jan, on the front page you have four Nirbhaya case convicts to be hanged on Jan 22. So now this is the sessions judge who has issued death warrants for convicts, four convicts in the Nirbhaya case, and it has been this is the case of December 2012. So now in 2020, these four convicts will be held on, will be hanged on Jan 22 at Tihar Jail in Delhi. And this is charges against student leader, but none held for JNU attack. So this is Bollywood actor Deepika Padukone who visited JNU to show solidarity with the students. And here it is said that Ayashi Ghosh, who is the JNU student union leader as such, and 18 others have been charged with vandalizing server room on campus. But then the JNU attacks which took place, and this none has been held. Below you have at least 50 killed in stampede at Soleimani's funeral in Iran. So this was the military general Qasem Soleimani who was killed in a US drone strike in Iraq near Baghdad airport. So his funeral in Iran, it saw at least 50 persons killed in stampede. So that's a huge crowd which came for it. And here you have government projects slower GDP growth. So now it is said government expects country's GDP to grow at slower pace of 5% for the full year 2019-20 as compared to 6.8% in the previous year. So this is the first advanced estimate released by Statistics Ministry, and you know, this is estimate is in line with the projections made by RBI also, which has revised GDP growth downwards to 5% for 2019-20 from 6.1%, which it mentioned in its October policy. So here you can see the reason being given. It says the growth in construction sector, you can see, will see a sharp decline to 3.2% as against a growth of 8.7% in previous year. So economic growth is at a 6-year low of 5%. And it has already been 5% in the first quarter of 2019-20, and for the whole year, all four quarters, whole year of 2019-20, government says it will be 5%. Then this is kicked, abused in police custody, says Sadaf Jafar. So this is former IPS officer SR Darapuri and Sadaf Jafar, who is Congress worker and social activist. They were arrested in UP and in the CA protests, and it is now that they have been released, say that Sadaf Jafar says that she was kicked, abused in police custody by male police officials, and was given communal slurs and statements like "go to Pakistan." Then Darapuri claimed he was denied a blanket in the cold and was also not provided food for 24 hours. And here you have government invites diplomats to visit Pakistan. So 5 months after decision on Article 370, government has invited the first group of Delhi-based diplomats to travel to Srinagar and assess the situation there. So earlier we had seen foreign diplomats were allowed, European diplomats were allowed. Now diplomats who are there in India, in Delhi, from foreign countries, so in embassies, so they will be allowed to travel to Srinagar and assess the situation there. On page 7, you have Ajit allays fears of transgender community about NRC CA. So this is transgender community that met state government of Maharashtra leaders, and it has been assured that transgenders would not be excluded from NRC as has happened in Assam, because they require a birth certificate, they require documents which they don't have. So on page 9, you have, it is up to states to provide 10% quota. So this is regarding Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, which have approached the Supreme Court that 10% economic reservation in government jobs and admissions to educational institutions, this has not been implemented as such. But central government responded to this saying that law is not implemented because it is the prerogative of the states to provide this 10% economic reservation. And below you have Army gets working on GOCO model to improve efficiency. So Army has started identifying potential industry partners to implement the government-owned contractor-operated model for its base workshops and ordnance depots. So this is GOCO model for Army. You can see. So this is important. So this is for infrastructure projects for Army. So the model used is GOCO. On the editorial page, the first editorial is a battle over welfare. So this is regarding Delhi assembly elections which have been announced, and AAP will hope that these elections are a referendum on its work, the government's work in Delhi. And below you have none for four. So this is regarding cricket. It says a 4-day test will make all cricket seem like limited over internationals. And this is retrieving ideas of democracy and nation. So this article talks about how the substantive versions of these ideas have been evoked in popular upsurge across country today. So ideas of democracy and nation, popular protests which are going on are for upholding the idea of democracy and the nation. And this is, there is a design flaw with this military post. So this is regarding Chief of Defense Staff. So we have seen the recent news that the Chief of Defense Staff post has been created, which will integrate all three, Army, Navy and Air Force. And also the first Chief of Defense Staff is the retired Army General, General Bipin Rawat, who has been appointed. So this article says that this is problematic because it also erodes civilian supremacy over defense establishment. On op-ed page, you have amidst a tragedy and opportunity. So this is regarding raging bushfires, which are presently news in Australia. These fires, forest fires happen even in India. So this article says that this gives a chance to deepen dialogue between India and Australia, including on energy issues as such. And this is the road to radicalization. So it says that oversimplification of factors that push an individual to engage in acts of violence will lead to poor policy making. This is regarding how violence results in process of radicalization and violence, how they are connected to each other. And talks about terror attacks too, like stabbing in London, etc. And below you have the domestic perils of Trump's adventurism abroad. So this is regarding Qasem Soleimani, the Iranian military general who was killed in Iraq near Baghdad airport by drones or by air attack as such from USA. So US President Donald Trump had approved it. So it says this has driven a deep wedge between political constituents at home. So we have seen how the political constituents in USA are divided between it. So it took place in Iraq, but there are consequences in USA. You can see the Democrats, Republicans, how they are divided over this issue, over escalation of tensions here now. So they want to limit US president's powers also, and anti-war protests are also going on. Then this is Center invites foreign envoys to Srinagar. So this continuation of the front page news which we saw. And then you have JNU professor Chandrasekhar quits panel to review data. So he says, I have lost faith in government after violence at university. So he was actually part of the panel, you know, that he has resigned from the government panel, which is there to review the country's economic statistical data, because he said he did not trust the government. So it was the statistics ministry which has constituted this standing committee on statistics. So it was chaired by former chief statistician Pranab Sen to improve the quality of data because of criticism of government over political interference. But then this member, C. R. Chandrasekhar, who is former JNU professor, has quit this panel. On page 13, you have 12 injured as NSUI ABVP workers clash in Ahmedabad. So this is Akhil Bharatiya Vidyarthi Parishad. So that is the students' wing of BJP, and NSUI, that is National Students Union of India. So the two student groups actually clashed in Ahmedabad, and it is said at least 12 persons including NSUI General Secretary Nikhil Savani were injured in the clash and were hospitalized. Then on international page, you have Iran threatens to set ablaze the places US likes. So when US President Donald Trump gave threats to Iran, saying that it will bring down 52 places, 52 sites, which Iran upholds, including Iranian cultural sites. So now Iran has given threats. So this escalation of tensions after military general Qasem Soleimani being killed by US in Iraq. Then this is Australia's curse returns as world's youngest government head. So he's heading a coalition government with the Green Party in Austria, and he's the world's youngest democratically elected leader and at the head of this coalition. So he's 33 years old, and he says he'll protect the climate and the borders. On business page, you have government may cut spending to curb deficit. So it says coming to on the back of poor private investment, now this curb on spending by government also will hurt economic growth further. And here you have reaction to Operation Twist as expected. So RBI had carried out three rounds of Operation Twist on buying and selling long-term and short-term securities, government securities in open market operations. So the RBI governor says that its result has been as expected. So high inflation is adversely affecting the economy. So to tackle that, as growth rate is retarding, to respond to that, government, the RBI had initiated this Operation Twist. And this is RBI to tap market supply for specialized supervision regulation cadre. So internal promotions will still account for 65% of category headcounts, but then market will be tapped for appointments to these specialized supervision and regulation cadre. And here you have India must create 70 million jobs to achieve $5 trillion economy by 2024. And this is what visiting senior minister of Singapore, Tharman Shanmugaratnam, he has said. He said 140 million jobs are needed in next decade. The talks between leaders took place here in India. And below you have mindset to blame for poor response to NPS. So this is regarding national pension scheme. So it is said only 10 lakh employees are covered under it. And pension funds regulatory and development authority says that the reason for this is people's view. And it says people's view need to be changed on NPS. So the earlier pension scheme was replaced by NPS, and NPS coverage as such is quite low, because the benefits which have been given earlier under the scheme, so NPS does not provide those same benefits. We should know the comparison as such too. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aashar.com. Thank you.